Hi, it's Deb from Deb's Days. It's Tutorial Tuesday and I have another project for you today. Today we're making a slim sleeve for our vaccination card. It's made from laminated fabric that we laminated ourselves and a piece of vinyl. The combination of the two makes a sturdy way for us to protect our cards. Before I get started, I publish new content frequently, so be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And check out the blog at debsdays.com for even more sewing and crafting projects. And don't forget, you can find the written version of a lot of my tutorials in my Etsy shop, Deb's Days Designs, including the other two vaccination card holders we've made, the one for one person that folds over and the one for two people. All right, back to this project. Along with your regular sewing supplies, for this project you will need a piece of fabric, a piece of iron-on vinyl, and a piece of clear see-through vinyl of at least 12 gauge. And since we're sewing vinyl, you'll need a Teflon sewing foot or some painter's tape. You can find the supply list with the cutting measurements at debsdays.com. I've added a link in the description below this video. And if you'd like the written version of this pattern, with the step-by-step instructions, photos, and a link to this tutorial video, it's available in my Etsy shop. I have that link down below as well. All right, let's get this project started. First, place your piece of fabric with the right side of the fabric facing up. Make sure it's been pressed well. We don't want any wrinkles in it. Now grab your iron-on vinyl. I have a link on Deb's Days where you can get it. Peel the paper backing off the piece of vinyl. Don't throw away that paper, we're going to need it. And center the sticky side in the middle of your fabric. Since we cut our vinyl a little bit smaller than our fabric, we'll have a little bit of space available on the outside, and that's a good thing. Smooth the vinyl so it sticks to the fabric nicely. Now place the shiny side of the paper on top of your vinyl. We're using it like a pressing cloth. Now because the vinyl is so sticky and I want to protect my iron, I actually add another piece of paper on top just to be safe. And then I follow the directions on my iron-on vinyl packaging to get it ironed on. Let it cool and peel the paper off. If you find any places where the vinyl didn't stick all the way, go ahead and use that piece of paper to iron it on a little bit better. Now fold your piece of fabric in half. Use your fingers to make a crease, and then I like to press it, but again, put it inside that paper. Let it cool. With it still folded, now we need to trim it down. We're going to cut it so it measures 4.5 inches across and 3 3/4 inches tall. Prepare your sewing machine by either adding your Teflon foot or by putting painter's tape on the bottom of your regular foot. We're going to first do some zigzagging to reinforce the fabric edges a bit. I like to do a little practice, adjusting my width and length of my stitches until I get the stitch I'd like. With the fold of the fabric at the top, we're going to start our stitching on the right side, about 1/2 inch up from the bottom. We're going to zigzag all the way around the entire piece so that we're covering those edges to reduce the fraying of the fabric. At the corners, make sure your needle's in the down position as you pivot. Make sure you're back tacking to secure the stitching and clip your threads. Now grab your piece of vinyl. With a folded edge of your fabric at the top, place your vinyl at the bottom and align it along the right edge, the left edge, and the bottom. This time we're going to use a straight stitch right inside that zigzag stitch. When you're sewing this clear vinyl, you want to make sure you have as few holes as possible, so make your stitch length a little bit longer. Again, start about 1/2 inch up from the bottom right corner and stitch all around all four sides. Again, with the needle down as you pivot at the corners, and again, back tacking to secure the stitching. If you see any loose threads, go ahead and pull them or clip them off. Now, even though we've done some zigzagging around the edge to help with the fraying, I like to add some additional fabric glue to the edges to make sure those threads stay in place. And just like that, just that easy, you have a nice protected vaccination card holder made from laminated fabric we laminated ourselves. If you have oilcloth fabric, fold it in half and add the vinyl. No zigzagging required on this one. Have old maps? Laminate those and make yourself a card holder out of those too. No zigzagging there either. Thanks for watching. See you next week with another project.